And we're back.
No problem.
We should sneak. So we're on level 2 of Cliaban Rilag. Came in through here. Around here. Explore these areas. Came out through here. There's a man and woman figure made of Aedra. That's locked. We can't get through. It's beyond our capabilities. So we came through. That's the door. Yeah, we looked at these. This area. This leads back to the main area, and we're about to forge forth into unknown. Or the unknown. Big open area. I hear something. Like breathing, or water, or wind blowing. There's an animat, of course. We have no idea how many. Besides this one? Oh boy. An Aedra animat. Let's weaken this one first. It doesn't look like we do anything to them. And yeah, don't use your fists. He keeps doing that. Let's try to take down this big guy. If we can. He's big. Concussive missiles. Boom. Puppet master. Some crowd control. Take over this one. If we can. There's another one here. Fireball. Whoever else wants to get in the way, you're welcome to. She's still trying to do that. He's still doing that.
How may I help?
Again. Did it fail? Oh, we're still trying to do it. Where are we? Where is she? This is her? Oh, she's gonna get interrupted left and right. Maybe just hit it. Blessing. Another concussive missile that way.
This thing is...
Is it still down? It got up. Okay. Boom. Knock it down again. It's a line of attack. It's gonna hurt us. But we've knocked this one down, so... I again. It's pretty tough.
Yes?
Endurance. Shield. Oh, she killed that one. Awesome. Now I'm free to do my spells. Yay. Amplified thrust off of Canna. One more concussive missile. Let me just see this. We've killed it! Let's go normal speed. One left, as far as we can see. Yay! Is that one holding anything special? The core. Awakened Aedra. A vibrantly hued piece of Aedra still humming with energy. In the core. +2 perception. This copper locket is a legacy of some of the Inguithin's early soul experiments. The crystal inside is filled with the essence of dozens of souls. While no one is entirely certain of its original purpose, it is believed that this was created in one of the first attempts to build and control animants. It is said that, unable to get out, some of the souls have lost their sanity, while others formed a unique collection consciousness. Sorry, guys. While others formed a unique collective consciousness that kept the memory and talents of each alive. Those who wear it will swear they hear voices talking to them, guiding their actions. The locket is scratched and inlaid with simple niloid patterns. I don't know that word. The crown base is decorated with a stylized bear head. Upon opening the locket, you see a six-sided crystal that appears dark at first. However, as you gaze into it, it warms with an orange glow. That's pretty freaking interesting. Let's hold on to that. I mean, is it a special thing? Or does it only increase +2 perception once we're all said and done? Fighters in iron, relentless and fierce as the thousands of foes.
I'll see what I can find.
Got it.
What's this? An armor rack. Fine scale armor and a soft hat. Oh, nice and soft. Images of men and women swinging hammers and heating iron over a forge fill this alcove. So we can't look at this huge thing? I mean, you'd think out of anything in this room we'd want to look at this, but no. Fine male armor. Is that it, then? And we don't have a way to get into that door. Let's look along this side again for any secret doors or anything like that. No. Well, what if we put that on? Would something immediately happen? And I'm wearing it. It's one door we can't get through.
A simple test.
You lie. I wonder if maybe something in this room. Maybe we're not high enough, obviously. At least in mechanics.
I shall be discreet.
Can't help but think I'm missing something here. I don't know. If we level up, he gets another level in mechanics, we can come back. I guess now we just leave? Pretty sure there's nobody out nowhere else we haven't looked. Gonna have to come back. Crap. That's no good. Here's the stairs. Where do we come in here? Yeah. Ah! Right, we came out the other area. The warriors turn as you exit the ruin, their painted faces betraying shock and anger. You were warned, Estremore. Okay. That's alright, we'll kill you. The wolf will probably run ahead.
Hey.
Try some fire on for size.
Yeah. How bad?
Eh?
Love.
Knocked out. The wolves are all knocked out.
Yes.
Yeah. I got it there. Kill these knocked out wolves. We can't kill the knocked out wolf. We won't kill it. Swing your blade.
Yes.
Oh my god, I guess we won't kill something that's knocked out. Okay.
Bunin Iyankyu and Ankyu Ibunin. Life in death and death in life. Magnificent.
If you say so. Well, they got eggs and milk. We can have breakfast. All right. Let's see.
Got it.
Oh, we're sped up here. Well, we're done with Cliaban Rilag for now. Oh, should we go to Caed and look around? I guess we should head on to Twin Elms after this. Or we could head back and fight that named Drake. Kinda wanted to gain another level first before we did that, though. Local fool is wanted to stronghold. Well, we're here. Can we just get rid of him? Send Firebrand. Where are we? We could visit ye old curio shoppy. Lizard skins, knuckle bones, and teeth of various sizes lie among the weeds. Essence shimmers within these bottles. Dozens of spider legs protrude from the necks of these bottles.
How do you do?
It's good to see you, my lord. I have all manners of odds and ends here, acquired from every corner of the Deerwood. Spider venom, scolder ears, anything you might wish. Swightenly. A Vithrak brain. Oh, I want to put it back. The large gelatinous brain of a Vithrak, whatever the hell that is. Though the Vithrak are known to possess impressive powers of the mind, there's no obvious source for said power on the brain's wrinkled surface. Cool. Pretty awesome. Alright. That's the curio shop. I haven't expanded the hedge maze yet, have I? Oh, the Warden's Lodge. Let's just head there. We just finished that. Warden Fergen. Fergen? One glass eye and several teeth are missing from the Scolder head. That's a Scolder head? Hmm. You hear about the bounties? This field journal contains sketches of Admet's sword, deer cap, and other common plants. Empty barrel.
Greetings!
This grizzled old man takes a puff from his pipe and nods at you. Was wondering when you'd be dropping by. Kith around here have been hit with more than their share of trouble of lot. Of late, I'm up to my ear in bounty offers. Figured at least one of these might interest someone with your skills. One of the most recent bounties. Now, I ought to warn you, there's a reason these bounties are still on offer. These are tough bastards, every one of them. If you're not up to it now, feel free to come back around when you're better prepared. In the meantime, here's a good batch to start us off. There's the astounding bounty on Sleer Cyrodiil's head, of course. Then there's the forest lurker haunting the trade routes, and this ogre shaman. Should fetch a good price. And the last one is, War Chief Iklak. I want to know about Sly Cyrodiil. This bounty comes all the way from New Hamar. Sir Sly Cyrodiil and some of his accomplices have escaped the prison there and killed two justiciars on the way out. The guards are itching after revenge. A man matching his description was seen near Magwin's Fork. He's well armed, and he'll have his friends with him, too. Tell me about the forest lurker. Let's see. Word is this big forest lurker's taken up residence in the Black Meadow, just off the main road. The merchants have been calling it the Dweller, and they want it gone before it starts chewing up their caravans. Tell me about the War Chief. War Chief Iklak. He's a Zoref, and if the name didn't trip you off. He moves around a lot, but he's been known to haunt the Veilwood from time to time. Folks want him dealt with before he takes up with a dragon. I can't choose one of the others. I have to go out. New task. I didn't say yes to that. I just wanted information about all of them. Oh, well. Last scene of Magwin's Fork. Suppose we can do that. Oh, we're doing all these? Okay. Okay. Didn't say yes to any of them, mind you. Righto. Whatever, I'll do it. Maybe that'll be the focus of next episode or two. You need to get up a level. So, our cleric endurance can get his mechanics up another level so we could advance further into what do you call it? I don't remember the name of the place. The names are way too foreign. Cliaban Rilag. Duh.
Ah, the famed rustic charm of the Deerwood.
Think so? This is rustic? What the hell, man? Can't look at anything in here, huh? Looks nice, though. I'll tell you that much. Rich savory stew bubbles over the hearth. All these doors. Are we gonna rest if we do that? The window on the other side of the curtain looks down on the perfect rose of a hedge maze. Sagani in Itumac. Nothing new to say. Nothing in the chest. Well, these are chests that we can fill. The wilderness of the Deerwood rambles on beyond the house. Ditto. Just looking around. I can't actually look at that, okay. The thick woven weir wool feels soft and warm. Yay! And we can look down on the first floor. Pretty cool. Oh, hey. Skirmish archer. Something you want? How do we get in here again? we overshot our mark. Barracks, library. Steward, dungeons, treasury. A ceremonial forge hammer of the Knights of the Crucible rests in the rack. It was a gift from Dunstan. Three greasy playing cards are hidden under the coverlet. It was all our soldiers that we hired. A sketch of a young elven woman with large eyes and a small, fine nose is tucked under the pillow. Yep, those elves and their small, fine noses, let me tell you. Well, we have to fix this area up. Spiders have taken up residence in the empty shells. Yeah, I gotta fix up the library. Pretty sure this is the stuff that was already here. This map shows the Deerwood's old colonial borders. A settlement called New Dunreed is marked in the place of present-day Defiance Bay. The treasury. Empty. So when can we take prisoners exactly? Jailer.
Hail, traveler.
Greetings, my lady. I'm here to maintain the cells for you. Should you take any prisoners in your travels, I'll make sure they're tended to as you see fit. Nobody in here right now, but I'm sure you'll change that soon enough. Cool. All these cells. Reason to look in them all. They are empty. I wonder if we can interrogate people after that. When they're jailed, of course. Oh, we will speak with the lady next episode. And next episode we'll probably take on some of these bounties. I mean, a forest lurker, just one forest lurker, should be easy. So, thanks for watching, see you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.